taboo, and this is Ask Super Sister. You've got questions, and I've got pomegranates. Well, I would if the farmer's market wasn't such a douche circus. Stupid import restrictions. You're tuned in to our gay episode.
Rah, rah, ah, ah,
ah. Well, I'll answer questions from people who practice an alternative lifestyle. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Some of my best friends are girls who kiss girls, and they're really good kissers. But I'll save that for the pay-per-view edition of the show. Wait, what? Stupid elves must have gotten into my secret plans. I mean, into the script. There are no plans. There's no pay-per-view channel. There's also no sex tape. There's no DNA evidence either. I'm saying too much. Let's move on. Anyway, if you'd like to ask me a question, gay or otherwise, please visit www.supersister.net. That'll work better than passenger pigeons, which tend to carry dysentery. Filthy bastards. Remember, these videos are not safe for work.
No good getting fired trying to get your freak on, you heard me?
I'm here to answer questions about love, sex, and monkeys. Not sex with monkeys, unless that's your thing. We couldn't get the approval from the FCC for a bestiality show. The cleanup alone would have been just way too much. Our first question comes from Kendra in Miami, and she writes, me and four of my girls went out drinking with my best friend for her birthday last night. We got completely wasted. Well, when I woke up, we were all naked and in bed together. I don't really remember what happened, but here's my problem. I think something happened between me and my friend who has really bad dandruff. I mean, like, she's got some really, really seriously bad dandruff. Most of my friends are really hot, but this one girl, well, she's really sweet. And we've all been friends since college, but it always looks like she just came in from the snow. How can I find out whether I got crotch dandruff in my panties without messing up our friendship? I'm here with you, Kendra. We're going to investigate this one like it was one of those CSI shows on TV. Or like America's Most Wanted. Definitely not like Sesame Street.
Elmo, love you.
You're going to go to the same bar. You're going to drink the same drinks. If you want to rush it, go ahead and put something in the first drink. If you're in a hurry.
Slip me a Mickey.
Then you'll all end up in the same bed, in the same room, where you've already set up a webcam connected to me. You'll also have a Bluetooth earpiece in your ear, and I'll be on the line listening. If I see you start going for old head and shoulders over there, I'll yell in your ear and aim you towards somebody tastier. I know what you're thinking. How can I be sure this won't end up on the internet, Super Sister? You can trust me here, Kendra. It's harder to make money on a four-way girl-on-girl sex session on the internet. Especially when one of them looks like they live in a snow globe. You have to run that stuff on DVD. Not that I would. Question number two comes from Jim in San Francisco. No stupid San Francisco jokes, guys. Come on. I work at a big name brokerage house downtown, and while I'm not ashamed of who I am, I don't make a big deal about it. However, I don't know how to deal with one thing. Every inch of my body is covered in glitter. I try to take showers, I've exfoliated, I even did a chemical peel. And still, my assistant notices a little glistening on my cheek or my hand like I was in twilight. Every weekend after I go out, I get a little shinier. And I'm worried that it'll affect my chances on getting promoted. What can I do? There's two things I can suggest. First, you should get yourself a whole lot of that WD-40 oil. And slather it all over yourself. Maybe in front of a mirror. Maybe spank yourself a little bit while you're doing it. Hang on second thought, this might get more glitter on you. Never mind. Let's try my second idea. Go to the matte counter and get them to match your skin tone as closely as possible. Then, before work every day, you're gonna slap that stuff all over your face like you were painting a house. You go for some touch-ups at lunchtime, and there you go. Now you're no longer the guy at work in glitter. You're a prima donna in makeup.
Work!
Isn't that better? No need to thank me. I love it when I'm helpful. Our last question is from Jessica in Houston. who has a really hot problem. I've been dating my girlfriend for 6 years. She's a bartender and we met at her job, which is also a dance club. We started living together 4 years ago. It was great, but we broke up last week. Nothing really bad. We just became more roommates than lovers, and I've offered to move out in a month or two when I save up some money. Here's the situation though. I still want to go to the club and dance, but I also totally want to sleep with the DJ, this smoking hot redhead with huge boobs. But she's been friends with my ex longer than we've known each other. But she's always kind of flirting with me, so what should I do? We have to look at what's important here. Okay, Jessica? How rockin' is this club? Woo! Is this just a place you like to go to dance, or is this your number one spot?
Coming for that number one spot!
Alright!
If there's lots of clubs, you should stop watching this video on the internet right now and go put your face in those boobs.
Drop below, girl.
You might not be able to go to that bar if you mess up the friendship between the DJ and the bartender. But if there are other clubs, that doesn't really matter. On the other hand, if your whole nightlife scene revolves around this one place, and if your only chance to shake your ass each week comes within these four walls, then you'll have to watch those boobs when she bends over to mix a song and stick your tongue down someone else's throat in the bathroom. The way God intended. What I'm saying here, Jessica, is you have to evaluate things for yourself. Can you still get your groove on if you munch that carpet? I can't answer these questions for you because I'm not a psychic. Or am I? This is what you'll be asking when you find a camera aimed at your bed. Don't blame me. Blame the Patriot Act. That sound means we're out of time. Or that Cher is doing a secret show in your town tonight. Next episode, we're mostly back to heterosexual topics. Unless you're a really hot girl and you wanna... Wait, that's probably not... My husband's looking at me. Or is he turned on? There's only one way to find out, and I can't do it on camera. Taboo out!